Okay, so we have to make our lover cocktail. So let me get my GoPuff. So I have my GoPuff order, and hopefully everything is in here. So we have Sprite. Needed that. The pink. Oh! Oh my god, I thought it was gonna be the big bottle. You know what? Actually, that's okay because I didn't need all that anyways. And then we got some lemons. I mean, lemons, limes. We got some lime, so let's get started. I'm doing Pink Whitney. This is the first time I've ever tried Pink Whitney. And I'm actually kind of scared because everybody on TikTok is like, this is the blackout drink. But it was pink, so I'm like, okay, lover, pink. So we're going with Pink Whitney. I'm actually really living for this right now because I'm going to get really drunk and just vibe out to the music. And I'm going to be able to just lay down in my bed afterwards. I don't have to go anywhere. It's going to be amazing. This is going to be like the lover martini. What do we want to name it? Hold on. Let me look at the tracks. Let me look at the tracks and see what kind of makes sense. Ooh. Okay, we're going to call this the Afterglow. We're going to call it the Afterglow Martini, okay? I just like that name a lot, so hopefully that song is amazing. Let me get the glass. When you do martinis, you definitely want to put your glass in the freezer. I've actually had this in the freezer for about like 15 minutes because you want it to be cold every time. I promise you, you do. I probably should do the sugar first. Usually I'll use a plate for this, but I don't feel like I want to get a plate. Sugar, and I just put some sugar on your plate or your paper towel, whatever. But what you're gonna wanna do is take your lime or lemon, whatever you prefer, and go around the edge like that. And this is for the sugar rim, cause I love me a sugar rim. You can do salt if you want, but I love me a sugar rim. It's kind of like a lemon drop. This is low key, we're kind of low key going for a lemon drop, but this is the Afterglow one. And dip it. Nice sugary rim. Is that enough? Because I like a sugary freaking rim. There we go. There we go. Nice and sugary. Okay. Boom. So then we're going to take your mixer. I already have ice in here. I'm going to do Sprite. And no, I'm not going to do Sprite. I lied. I'm going to do... This is going to be my chaser, actually, from when I do the shots. What should it? Maybe I'll do a dash of Sprite. I'm going to do some lemon juice. Lemon juice. I'm going to do some lemon juice and I'm going to do some simple syrup. That is going to be our blend. Let me get the shot glass to pour. I have cute little shot glasses and it's pink. Everything's going to be pink theme. Like the mango's going to be pink. The drink's going to be pink. We're going pink, okay? So start with your liquor. Oh, let me smell it. It smells like my freshman year of college. It's like a strong pink lemonade scent. Kind of reminds me of Burnett's. Okay, ooh, one shot. Maybe like a shot and a half, because this is a small mixer. And your simple syrup. Like a lot of that. Do some lemon juice. It's really gonna taste like pink lemonade, for sure. And then take that lime that you used. And you're gonna squeeze two limes, two. The other two, one is gonna be for my, you know, when I take shots, and the other will be a garnish. So squeeze. I'm gonna top it with this right. Not a lot though. Situation, I don't have a top for my shakers. I'm gonna put this, on top. Oh, it's cold. And now we're gonna pour. Our pretty drink, hopefully it's pretty. Oh yes, it's like a light pink, like the album cover. There you go, a period. Okay, slit in this so I can garnish. Cute, she's slaying, period. Don't mind my nails, I'm getting them done tomorrow. Okay, I'm gonna take a little sip to see if it's like worth the hype that I'm getting right now. Oh my god, you guys. Oh my god. The Afterglow. She's that girl. Y'all, please. You have to make this. This is so... This is so fucking good. And I'm happy that I tapped it off with the Sprite. Like, It's not Sprite-y. It just has like a little, oh my God, this is so good. The Afterglow is that girl, period. Okay, now let's go listen to the album. I'm really excited.
This Pink Whitney nonsense. This gonna knock me out. I feel it. I feel like it is. I really feel like it is. I'm scared. So today we're gonna be reacting to Taylor Swift's Lover. Right now I've been going through all her discography because I just really admire the fan base. Like the Swifties, they go so hard. And the thing about it, it's not like I had not listened to Taylor Swift before this journey. When she first came out, I did listen to Fearless and I did listen to Speak Now, but somewhere along the lines I just kind of fell off and like I just stopped listening to her. So like now I've started again because I had heard Folklore and I was like, wait a minute, I'm liking this. Maybe I need to tap back in and see like the other six albums she's released, because I like music. I like, you know, it doesn't matter what kind of music you're making, I'm always gonna check it out. But the thing about the Swifties is like they go so hard for her. So I'm like, there has to be a reason behind this. And the reason is Taylor Swift is just like a great singer-songwriter, especially songwriter. So, hey, we're here. We're checking it out. And I decided to go with Lover because one of my mutuals on TikTok, shout out to Paris. She told me I need to listen to either Reputation or Lover, I believe. She might have said something else too, but I just believe when I asked her, I remember her saying Reputation and Lover. And she likes the pop albums. So I'm like, I feel like I'm going to like the pop albums too. The only thing is most of the Taylor I've listened to has not been pop other than Midnight. So I don't really hear her in that element too often. So, we're going to see. And we're going to be doing makeup. I'm going to try to go for like a pinky glam look, but I'm not no makeup artist. Let's just get that clear right now. I'm just putting on my makeup. I just know how to do my makeup, but I am not MUA. I know how to put the thing on and look cute. That's it. But we're not going to do anything extravagant because I don't know how to do that. And we turn. Hey. Okay, let's just take a shot. Hi. Oh, God. Okay, so Lover is 18 songs and it is about 1 hour and 1 minute. So good party time. We're having a Taylor party. Our Taylor drink. We have the shot. That's pink as well. We're going for a pink look. We have like it's perfect. It is perfect. So I thought that the bottle was gonna be the big one. It's actually the small one, but so I was planning on taking shots most of the time, but only have like about this much left. So I'm gonna take a shot every time she says something that really gags me, but it has to gag me a lot because I don't have that much liquor left. So it has to be like, whoa. Let's get started. Why am I nervous? It's given Netflix movie.
How many days did I spend thinking about how you did me wrong, wrong, wrong? Lived in the shade you were throwing till all of my sunshine was gone, gone, gone. And I couldn't get away from ya. In my feelings more than Drake, so yeah.
Your name not the Drake on my lips,
tongue tie. Free rent living in my mind. But then something happened one
magical night. It's given Netflix movie.
I forgot that you existed. Kill me, but it didn't.
Okay, let him know.
It isn't love, it isn't hate, it's just indifference.
This beat is just like giving me Netflix original movie. Like, tell me right now you have not heard a beat like this on a Netflix movie, like set in high school, young adults. Come on. Tell me right now. This song reminds me of like The Kissing Booth and To All the Boys I Loved Before. Tell me I'm wrong. That's what it sounds like. Not saying that it's a bad thing. It's just, that's what it sounds like to me.
Popcorn as soon as my rep started going down, down, down.
Oh.
Laughed on the schoolyard
as soon on her as downfall.
I tripped up and hit the ground, ground, ground.
I don't know what kind of eyeshadow to do. I'm not
a... And I would've stuck around for ya. Would've fought the whole town, so ya. Would've been right there front row. Even if nobody came to your show.
Okay.
But you said... kill me, but it didn't.
Interesting.
And they were, it's all just a blur. I forgot that you existed. And I thought that it would kill me, but it didn't. love it, isn't hate, it's just indifference.
So, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay. That song was cool. It wasn't my favorite. And I maybe because it was, I don't know, like something about the, I don't know. That it was straight though. Like, it was good. It wasn't like bad, but it wasn't like giving me life as I needed it to as an intro. Like, I probably would have liked to hear that somewhere else in the album, but it was cool though. It was cool. It was upbeat, but it definitely was giving me like Netflix movie. Yeah, it was nice. So, you know, we barely started the makeup. One song in and barely started makeup. I don't know how to do eyeshadow. So, I mean, like, I can just put like a little color, but like all that blending, you're not going to see no 2016 crazy eyeshadow right here, right now, because I don't know how to do that. But I'm going to try to do something. I know I want it to be like pinky and like white. So we're trying something. We don't know. I probably should have not had the lashes on before I did this, but whatever. Okay, so the next song is Cruel Summer. I know the song. We love this song, but I'm still going to play it because I just want to get the whole vibe of the album in full. I'm about to drink to Cruel Summer.
Price, you know that I bought it. Killing me slow, out the window. I'm always waiting for you to be waiting below. Devils roll the dice, angels roll their eyes. What doesn't kill me makes me want you more.
Yo, why do I feel like Belly right now? This time I turned pretty, have my belly drink. Because this really looks like her little margaritas. And then Cruel Summer's playing, Where's My Comrade? Literally, where is my comrade? Cruel Summer is a great song. You can't deny its greatness. It's a great song.
I'm drunk in the back of the car. And I cried like a baby going home from the bar. Said I'm fine, but it wasn't true. I don't want to keep secrets just to keep you. And I snuck in the
garden
gate. Every night that summer just to steal my
hey, head. And did, and did. And did, and did. Had to take a shot for that one. I'm sorry. That part of that song gags me every time. Like this, like bruh, she should have started the album with Cruel Summer. I'm gonna die on that hill. I'm sorry. This song is like the perfect pop song. Like the beat, production, lyrics, everything, the way it flows. Like it is the perfect pop song. And that's why sometimes you can just not deny people's artistry, bruh. Because you don't have to listen to Taylor Swift. I don't even have to listen to Taylor Swift. But I like music and I like artistry and I cannot deny talent. Like that's just one thing I cannot do. And if you're denying talent, then you're just a hater. Like sit here and tell me that Taylor Swift does not have hits and does not make good songs, then you are a hater, period. There's a lot of artists that I don't really like listen to on the regular, but I know makes good music and has hits. Same thing. You can come for her and talk about her in other areas if you want to. I don't care what you do, but as a music person and as a listener, you cannot come for her music. I'm sorry. Case is dismissed. Case is dismissed because Cruel Summer is a great pop song. So continue. Get it. Great song. Great song. We are not getting anywhere in the makeup. We're not. I have like the world's smallest mirror. I need like a mirror for my desk, but I don't have one. So the next song is Lover, and I've already heard this one, but we're still gonna listen to it because, you know, gotta listen to the whole album in full. Gotta get the whole vibe. Maybe you just wanna. This made me want to slow dance with somebody in like a dive bar.
This is our place.
It's gonna look a mess. It's gonna look a mess because I don't know what I'm freaking doing. Don't do eyes.
Lover, ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand with every
guitar
scar on my head? Boys has been blue, all swollen.
This is just giving me the time I turn pretty. I'm turning pretty right now. Never experienced this. Like, why have I never experienced these kind of feelings? I'm telling you right now, if you like literally put a gun to my head and said write a song that's like this, about somebody that you felt this way before, I'll be like, oh my god, well, these are my last moments. Because I can't even think of one person I would write this freaking song about. Taylor Swift is lucky to have loved. I tell you that.
Lover.
Really good song. I'm really feeling Cruel Summer and Lover right next to each other. I feel like that should have started the album off. The other song probably works somewhere else, but I have not like got through the album yet, so I can't tell you where I think it goes, but I definitely don't think it goes at the top. And I'm not saying that I don't like the song, I just think it could possibly fit somewhere else. Like, Cruel Summer is just such a great song. And sometimes you can start your album with the hit that you put out and as a single. I know some people don't like to do that, but you can. Britney Spears does that. She literally comes in, Baby One More Time, boom, boom, boom. Like, I'm coming with my hit that has been on the radio, wrecking y'all brains. She started the album strong, and she came in with another song. Like, hold on. Because I'm about to pull it up for y'all really quickly. Because Baby One More Time is definitely one of my favorite albums. I actually have that on vinyl. I'm not playing with that album. Britney. Yeah, Baby One More Time. And then right after that, Crazy. Then she goes into Sometimes. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like Lover should start with Cruel Summer and then into Lover and then the next song. Okay, so the next song is The Man. Update on my feelings right now. I don't really feel like super lit. I feel good. I know I probably shouldn't have said that because I don't know the wrath of Pink Whitney. So this, I could feel good now, but by the end of the album, this album is an hour. So by the end, we're only on song number 3. Like, by the end of the album, I could be like blackout. But let's just hope that my Taylor Knight doesn't do that to me. But I feel okay. I feel like good, but not like, woo! Like, so the next song is The Man. The Man. What's that going to be about? What's that going to be about? The Man. Who is The Man? Who is she talking about? We'll see.
Okay. I would be complex. Ooh. I would be cool. They'd say I played the field before I found someone to commit to. And that would be okay for me to do.
She talking about her tabloids. People talking about her. Is that what she talking about? She talking about people talking about her all the time.
West I had made would make me more of a boss to you. Mm-hmm. I'd be a fearless leader. I'd be an alpha type. When everyone believes ya. What's that like? I'm so sick of running as fast as I can.
Okay.
Wondering if I'd get there quicker if I was a man.
Man.
And I'm so sick of them coming at me again. Cause if I was a man, then I'd be the man. I'd be the man. I'd be the man.
Hey.
Is there a hustle?
I like that beat. Who did that? I know it was that. Oops, that was an accident. I know it was that man. The man that we shall not name. Jack Antonoff. Because that man does something to me production-wise. He always comes through for me. I love me some Jack. Because Jack knows what he's doing in that booth. Period. Nobody could ever, ever tell him otherwise. Because he is a super producer. Like, I wish I could just sit there and watch. I know what that man, though. He always be pissing me off because he always just does great shit. And I'm like, stop what you're doing. Stop what you're doing. Actually, don't stop. You got to keep making music because you're good at it. Okay. I like this beat. And I like what she's talking about. I'm going to tell you what this sound like, but I'm going to wait.
Put in the work. They wouldn't shake their heads and question how much of this I deserve.
Real, okay, yup, what she said. Uh-huh, I can relate to that, girl. Mm-hmm. They wouldn't shake their heads and question how much I deserve. What I was wearing, if I was rude.
Oh, God, bruh.
Oh God. And they would toast to me, or let the players play. I'd be just like Leo in Saint-Tropez. Not Leo.
Oh my God, bro.
Taylor Swift is so funny. Taylor Swift is so funny to me. Cause she just gonna tell it. She be talking her shit. Lil Taylor be talking her stuff. That's why I can't do nothing but respect it, bro. Like, she be talking her shit. This is a fuck you song. This is a fuck you song to a lot of people. Press, tabloid, this is... If I was a man, y'all wouldn't be doing all this. If I was a man, y'all wouldn't be doing all this. You guys would be praising me. Let me just go put on my girly makeup because... I ain't even gonna get into all that. I'm not gonna get into it. But I know what she's saying. I know what she's saying. I'd be the man. What's it like to brag about raking in dollars and getting bitches and models? And it's all good if you're bad, and it's okay if you're mad. If I was out flashing my dollars, I'd be a bitch, not a baller. They paint me out to be bad. This is so funny hearing her like this. This is so funny hearing her like in this pop bag, because I don't hear Taylor like this often, or at least the songs I've heard from her. I mean, of course, the ones I've heard on the radio and everywhere, like in the store, radio, all that stuff. Like, that's the only time I hear Taylor pop. Like, when I'm listening to Taylor, like in my room and stuff, or wherever I'm at, it's always like, you know, that folklore. Like, I always go back to folklore like that. I listen to that all the time, Evermore. Like, that is usually how I'm hearing her. So hearing her in this like straight pop, like all the way through, it's good. It feels good. It's good. She's good at it. I mean, she's an artist. She's good. She's great. I really like this beat though. And I know that man, that little man did it. I know it. I'm gonna look it up later. I don't have time because I wanna keep listening. But I know he did. I know he did. Go running as fast as I can. Tell him. Think of them coming at me again. Coming at me again. Just stick with it. On my neck. I'm taking a shot at this. Cause this is real. This is real. This is real. Listen, production on fire. What she's talking about, real. It's a go for me. I'm liking it. I really think she should have started the album with Cruel Summer and went into, like, this is getting me. Yeah, I Forgot You Existed definitely should have fit somewhere else, because, like, yeah, those three right there in a row work for me.
I'm feeling lit yet? No, not really. Makeup is barely even there.
You gotta trust the process. I know that's crazy. You gotta trust the process, though. You gotta trust it. So the next song is The Archer. We go from the band to The Archer. Burn. All right, let's see. Combat. Wait. I'm ready for combat. I say I don't want that. Why is it? What if I hate a song that's brewing. And you know why I hate it? Because I'm going to love it. Because I love when it's brewing at the beginning. I don't even know what the real beat sounds like. And I'm like, and it sounds heavenly, though. It sounds like, I'm scared. Because cruelty wins in the movies. I've got 100 thrown out speeches I almost said to you. Okay, yeah. Real. Easy they come, easy they go. I jump from the train, I ride off alone. I never grew up, it's getting so old. Help me out. Screaming, my neighbors are gonna be like, what's that? I never grew up. Real. Never grew up, it's getting so old. That Realest thing you ever wrote. I gotta take a shot of that. I'm sorry. Oh my god, I gotta take a shot to that. I feel that. Yikes. This is sounding ethereal. Oh god. Oh my god. I'm nervous about it. I love songs like this. I like stuff that sounds out of body. And this is sounding out of body. Watch there be a beat change and I'm gonna really lose my mind. I'm right off alone. I never grew up. It's getting so old. Help me hold on to you. Help me. I've been the archer. Oh my god, I hear some. I've been the prey. Who could ever leave me, darling? But who could stay? Dark side. A search for your dark side. This is making me like. What if I'm alright? Oh my god. I know that crazy man Jack Antonoff made this song because this is giving melodrama and it's the beat boom boom boom, but like I feel like I need to be like in a, I love this song. Oh my god. Woo, this is like, oh my god, I need to do my contour right, right here. Oh my god, it's giving ribs and I cut off my nose just to spite my face, and I hate my reflection. Ooh, they do. For years and years, awake in the night, I pace like a ghost. Ooh. The room is on fire, invisible smoke, and all of my heroes die all alone. Help me hold on to you. Ooh. I've been the archer. Her voice, her voice sounds mature on this, especially that part right there. Who could ever leave? Like, she sounds like just, this is Taylor Swift. Like, bruh, like this is what's throwing me off, because it's like, but you know what, maybe she's just versatile, because like I will hear songs by her and I'm like, okay, yeah, that's Taylor Swift. Then I hear another song, I'm like, that's Taylor Swift. Like, and they all sound good, but in their different way. Like, this is just like this. I really like, is this album considered dream pop? Because this song is dream poppy ish. And in my last video, I said I need, once I heard Gold Rush, I was like, Taylor Swift would probably sound good on a dream pop album, like a strictly dream pop. I'm talking like Heaven or Las Vegas type of dream pop album, like full throttle. But I haven't heard the rest of Lover, so we'll see. But after I listen to it, you know, I'm gonna do my research and like, you know, get down to the nitty gritty, producers, all, you know, all that stuff. But I like it. I love this song. This song is giving. Who could stay? Can you see right through me? I see right through. I do. All the king's horses, all the king's men couldn't put me together again. Cause all of my enemies started out friends. Woo! All of my enemies started out friends. I'm not gonna take a shot for that one. I'm gonna take a drink. Taylor Swift, this song is good. You, I've been the archer. I've been the prey. Who could ever leave me, darling? This song is going crazy. Who could stay? Come back to how she started the song. Come back. I love that. The beat was going. This is why I like Jack Antonoff, because I know he did that. I don't have to look that up. I know he did that. That, see, bruh, the album should have started at Cruel Summer, because that is a strong top four. Like, Cruel Summer, Lover, The Man, and then that. Why would she do that? Why would she put I Forgot You Existed right at first? I'm dying on the hill that should have been somewhere else. Because, like, that song is great. That's my favorite so far. Period. And I love Cruel Summer. But that the Archer is my favorite right now. Great song. Great. Like, 10. That is a 10 song. 10. 10 out of 10. That is good. Maybe I should take a shot to that one. Y'all, this Pink Whitney. Whitney. If this Pink Whitney does me bad, I'm going to be angry. Angry. The Archer. That was a banger. The next song is I Think He Knows. I got my blush on my freaking... Two dots. You only got to do two dots. So the next song is I Think He Knows. It's giving Netflix movie again.
I think he knows his footprints on the sidewalk lead to where I can't stop. Go there every night. I think he knows his hands around a cold glass make me wanna know that body like it's mine.
Yep, period.
He got that boyish look that I like in a man. I am an architect, I'm drawing up the plans. It's like I'm 17, nobody understands. No one understands. He got my heartbeat skipping down 16th Avenue.
This is given to all the boys I loved before. It's not bad. You see me over here, I'm like, main character moment. But it's just given that main character moment. And I think this and I Forgot You Existed would have went perfectly next to each other. They should have brought that one down next to this. And then, yes. Yes, I think. This album came out when she was dating Joe, right? I know that.
Lyrical smile, indigo eyes, hand on my thigh. We could follow the sparks, I'll drive. Lyrical smile, indigo eyes, hand on my thigh. Where we gonna go?
I'm gonna put that in the category with I Forgot You Existed. It's very upbeat, poppy, very like, you know, made for TV, made for radio. Because The Man, I'm not gonna say even made for TV or radio, because The Man and Cruel Summer, I know Cruel Summer is on, The Man sounds like that, and then I know Cruel Summer is everywhere. So I'm gonna say that I Forgot You Existed and I Think He Knows kind of remind me of each other, and they're like the same vibe, for real. And that's not a bad thing. They're both cool songs. But my favorite so far is definitely Cruel Summer through The Archer. Like, that is just, like, hitting for me. Like, when I say hitting, it is hitting. But let's keep going. So the next song is... I'm actually starting to feel a little wavy. So the next song is Miss Americana and the Heartbreak Prince. Heartbreak Prince. Miss Americana. Isn't the name of her movie? Or something on Netflix? I've seen that. I mean, I haven't watched it, but I've seen it on Netflix.
You know I adore you. I'm crazier for you than I was at 16. Lost in a film scene. Waving homecoming queens. Marching band playing, I'm lost in the lights. American glory faded before me. Now I'm feeling hopeless. Ripped up my prom dress, running through rose thorns. I saw the scoreboard and ran for my life. No cameras catch my pageant smile. I counted days, I counted miles. To see you there.
know she was gonna come in like that. That's what I'm saying, bro. It's the production for me. I didn't know it was gonna come in. Okay, I like that. It's giving very much. I'm riding down the street. I'm feeling good. I like that. Oh, that's making me feel good. Okay. That's what it feels like. Go back. You play stupid games, you win stupid prize. And before me, I'm feeling helpless. The damsels are depressed. Boys will be boys then. Whoa. The damsels are depressed and boys will be boys. Shot to that. I'm gagged. Well, all the Pink Whitney's gonna be gone. Cause I only have a little bit left and I'm only on song number, I don't even know, seven? Is it seven, I think? Cheers, Taylor. Bad, bad girl. The whole school is rolling fake dice. You play stupid games, you win stupid prizes. It's you and me, there's nothing like this. This Americana and the Heartbreak Prince. I love it. That's just so cunty and just so girl like, okay, period. That is okay. That is so just cunty, and I'm just like eating that up. I'm loving that. I'm loving this song. It's just like, and that's, it would have worked so good next to the Archer. If y'all gonna hate me for saying this, I'm really sorry. I'm just like, it just the way my brain works, and it's just like, I like just order with things. And I just feel like that would have worked. I don't really wanna, cause nobody's gonna win. You should come home, and I don't want you to go. I don't really wanna fight, cause nobody's gonna win. You should know. I've never heard this song ever in my life. Like, where has this song been? That someday we're gonna win. It's you and me. Slowing it up. They whisper in the hallway, she's a bad, bad. Sing about it, because I know she's talking about how people be talking about her, and it's like that's what they be saying, whispering. Y'all still talking though. Keep talking. That song is good. I like that song a lot, actually. Ooh, that in the Archer. I'm eating that up. Okay, makeup is actually starting to look good. I can't really tell on the camera, but this little mirror that I have, I don't have a big one, is kind of giving me something. Okay, so the next song is Paper Rings. I like that name. I wonder what that's gonna sound like. The moon is high, like your friends were the night that we first met. Went home and tried to stalk you on the internet. Now I've read all of the books beside your bed. The wine is cold, like the shoulder that I gave things, but I'd marry you. Oh, you know what? You know what I was about to say? This was giving me like Old Navy commercial. And then as soon as that chorus started, I recognized that I know this song. And I have heard this song on commercials. So, yeah. There's just some songs that like you can very much tell that they're like made for like entertainment. Like made, not entertainment, made for TV, made for commercial, made for movie, like, and this is definitely one of them. And I feel like the first song, and I think he knows it, it's the same vibe. Like, that's how I know Paper Rings. Like, I didn't even know that was the name of this song, but I've heard that song, like, out and about. You can just always tell when they're made for that. Like, they have a sound that is just, like, commercial. Okay, so that was Paper Rings, and I mean, pretty much, I didn't really have a reaction to that one because I've, like, heard that song already, and I've heard it 1,000 times, but it's, like, not one of my favorites, like, something that, like, I've went and, like, listened to on my own time. Now, Cruel Summer and Lover, I have, so, like, I always jam out to those because I, like, absolutely love that song, those songs, both of those, but that was cool. I mean, it's not a bad song, but it's very Old Navy to me. and that is not an insult. That is not an insult. It just sounds like it a little bit. Next song is Cornelia Street. I know this song. Love this song. So I will be singing this song. Have to. I don't feel drunk.
I feel like I shouldn't say that though, because the Whitney might sneak up.
We were in the backseat, drunk on something stronger than the drinks in the bar.
Okay. This makes me want to go to New York so bad.
I walk Cornelia Street again.
It's kind of crazy that she would never walk that street again. Wild. I got a city like that. That is so true though, like she'll never walk that street again. Like I don't think she's exaggerating, because I have a friend that literally will not come to where I live because her boyfriend used to live over here, and it's just like real, like that heartbreak is so real where it's like I can't even reminisce around those parts. It's just too traumatizing. Like it's just too, you know, reminiscing, and nobody likes to reminisce. I don't care how much we do it. I know me personally, I hate to reminisce, because like then I just really just start getting into my feelings, and it's a whole downward spiral of just thinking about the past. And like my dad always tells me, like, you know, you can't think about it because it's already over and done with. You cannot even dwell because you're in the present. You have to keep going to the future. So you just, you can't. So I feel it. I feel that.
Barefoot in the kitchen, sacred new beginnings that became my religion. Listen.
Damn, I got a Cornelia Street. I just realized I do. I got like two Cornelia Streets. Ever freaking again. I cannot find my black eyeliner. Now I'm starting to think I'm a little drunk because I can't find my eyeliner.
I know that's right.
That is a good song. Here we are at the next song. And the next song is Death by a Thousand Cuts. And let me tell you something. I see this song everywhere. So many of my mutuals talk about this song. It is ridiculous. My best friend, Haley, talks about this song. So I am like, this better be the greatest freaking song I've ever heard. Because the way y'all talk about Death by a Thousand Cuts is actually insane. So it better be that girl. Okay? And I'll be putting my lip gloss on when it's on. Because now we're almost done with the makeup. So it better be eating. Because my lip gloss is my favorite part of my makeup routine. So this better be my favorite part of the album. I'm just saying. I wasn't expecting to start like this. We're getting the Holy Ghost. Taylor Swift? Where I'm so confused.
Saying goodbye is death by a thousand cuts. Flashbacks waking me up. I get drunk, but it's not enough. Cause the morning comes and you're not my baby. I look through the windows of this love. Even though we boarded them up. Chandelier still flickering here. Cause I can't pretend it's okay when it's not.
What?
It's death by a thousand cuts.
My neighbors probably think something is happening. Hold on. Let me do my arm so I don't fuck it up. Because we need to talk about this very quickly. Pause. What was that coming in? I know it was... I know Jack's doing that. What is that? I was not expecting that. How it was going. I wasn't expecting a whole lot of... fantasy energy. What? I like that. We're going to run it back a little bit because I need to... Hold on. I need to hear one more time.
Because
first it was having that, you know, movie soundtrack sound. But hold on. Then it turned into something dream poppy. Hold on.
Saying goodbye is death by a thousand cuts. Flashbacks waking me up. I get drunk, but it's not enough. Cause the morning gone. It's okay when it's not.
Is that
death by a thousand cuts? I try to kill my time. I take the long way home.
Oh!
Traffic lights, if it'll be alright. They say
deeper. I have to take a shot from the bead. It's like the way it's like, the way it's like levitating up and up. Oh my God, I need to be in the room. Jack, please email me something. DM me. I literally like, I would love that if I, and I know I look crazy asking you this with having my lip liner on, but listen, this is how you know I'm serious because I'm real. I'm not going to doll this up when I'm asking you right now. I want to be in the studio when you are making something because I know you made this beat. I don't even have to look it up. I know you did because I know it. I know it because I know you. And this is like, I just want to see the process, okay? I don't even want to be a producer. I just want to see the process. I just love music so much. And it's like, that just, I wish I could see it in action. Please, let me watch. I promise. You will be doing me a great service in my life. And this is how you know I'm serious. I'm asking you this while I'm doing my lip liner. And my lip liner has to be perfect. You're not supposed to be talking while you're doing it. Jack, I'm dead ass serious. Let me in the fucking studio. Let me in there. Just know I would really take that seriously. You know, I'm not messing around here. I really would. This sounds crazy. I tried to kill my time. I take the long way home. I ask the traffic lights if it'll be alright. They say I don't. No. And what once was ours is no one's now. I see you everywhere. The only thing we share is this small town. You said it was a great love. Me and my ex coded. The ages. But if the story's over, why am I still writing pages?
Why?
Saying goodbye is death by a thousand cuts. Flashbacks waking me up. I get drunk, but it's not enough. Cause the morning comes and you're not my baby. I look through the windows of this love. Even though we boarded them up. Chandelier still flickering here. Cause I can't pretend it's okay when it's not. It's death by a thousand cuts. My heart, my hips, my body, my love. Find a part of me that you didn't touch. Oh. Gave up on me like I was a bad drug. Now I'm searching for signs in a haunted club. Our songs are that's what I do. This girl is crazy. This girl is crazy. That's what I do. I'm searching for signs in a haunted club. That's how it feels. Oh my God. Oh, my friends are right. Then my friends are right. You didn't touch. Gave up on me like I was a bad drug. Now I'm searching for signs in a haunted club. Our songs, our films, united we stand. Our country, guess it was a lawless land. Quiet my fears with the touch of your hand. Paper cut stings from a paper thin plan. My time, my wine, my spirit, my trust. Trying to find a part of me you didn't take up. I did all that. Oh my God. Oh my God, bruh. My everything. Everything. I'm literally searching for a part that you did not take up. Everything. This pisses me off. This is making me angry. Death by a thousand cuts. Oh, now I understand. I now understand why y'all like this song. Mm-hmm. Now I understand. Now I understand. I get it now. I get it. Hips, my body, my love. Trying to find a part of me that you didn't touch. Gave up on me like I was a bad drug. Now okay. I'm searching for signs in a haunted club. Our songs, our films, united we stand. Our country, guess it was a lawless land. Quiet my fears with the touch of your hand. Paper cut stings from a paper thin plan. My time, my wine, my spirit, my trust. Trying to find a part of me you didn't take up. Give you too much, but it wasn't enough. But I'll be alright, it's just a thousand cuts. I get drunk, but it's not enough.
Okay.
Cause you right know now. My baby, I look through the windows of this love. Even though we boarded them up. Chandelier still flickering here. Cause I can't pretend it's okay when it's not. No, it's not. Shooting. here.
I like that one too. I feel like sequencing is off in this album. Cause Death by a Thousand Cuts and Cornelia Street should have been by Miss Americana. It should have. I'm sorry. Paper Rings, I Forgot You Existed, and I Think He Knows needed to be next to each other. Close to each other. Maybe not one at the other, but closer to each other. Cause that just, they all have a certain sound, and that sounded like Miss, like, is that production? Oh my god, Lover is kind of eating low-key. It's cutty. It's like, I know Lip looks banging. That's what I know. I think it looks cute. What y'all think? I don't know. I feel like I'm at the Taylor party. Now we can party. Because now I got my makeup done. We pre-gamed. Now we can party. I don't have that much liquor left. I'm not even going to lie. I probably have 2 shots left. And then I have one more cocktail at my shaker. So let's see. Let's hope it goes from 11:18. So the next song is London Boy. I love me a London man. Boy. I just love London, period. I want to move there so bad. So I feel like I'm going to like the song.
Because... we can go driving in on my scooter.
Give it Harry, stop. Like, I was kind of like took him back with the accent. Oh my God. Damn, I love Atlanta, man. I do. It's just some accents. Like, I'm going to eat up an accent every time.
We can go driving in on my scooter. You know, just run London.
Oh. What?
I love my hometown as much as Motown. I love SoCal. And you know I love Springsteen. Faded blue jeans, Tennessee whiskey. Artists, but that's not where mine lives. You know I love a London boy. I enjoy walking Camden. Walking
okay.
If you spend time in London, like, if you really spend time in London, and I spend time in London, this is 110% facts. Everything she's saying is facts. Like, they like the American smile, they like the accent, you go around Camden, Mark, oh my God. I want to move there so bad. Like, I want to move there so bad. I love me a London boy. Love me London, everything, period.
Love Island, Love Island.
Oh my God, I cannot wait to go back to London. This song is making me want to go back to London so bad.
Babes, don't threaten me with a good time. They say that's where the heart is.
Taylor watched a little bit too much Love Island, or she definitely is walking around London doing her matins, because, babe.
But God, I love the English. You know I love a London boy. I enjoy nights in Brixton, Shoreditch in the afternoon. He likes my American smile like a child when her eyes are here for you.
Period. I just had to take a little selfie for my Instagram because I'm, you know, doing me. London boy. I like that. I actually like that song a lot because I'm just an eater up of London, so I'm sorry. I'm gonna like anything that's London about. Like, I love that. I love that a lot. Makeup looks good. I had to take a little bathroom break, but I looked in the mirror. I was like, oh, she's serving part. So, next song is Soon You'll Get Better featuring The Chicks. For some reason, I feel like this is gonna have like a... everything's been poppy. For some reason, I feel like it's gonna have a country feel. I think. I say? What I say?
The buttons of my coat were tangled in my hair. In doctor's office lighting, I didn't tell you I was scared. That was the first time we were there. Holy orange bottles, each night I pray to you. Desperate people find faith, so now I pray to Jesus too.
Orange bottle, what she talking about?
And I say to you, ooh, I, soon you'll get better. Ooh, I, soon you'll get better.
How do we go to super pop to this? This is getting sad. Could you have to? No.
I know delusion when I see it in the mirror. You like the nicer nurses. You make the best of a bad deal. I just pretend it isn't real. I'll paint the kitchen neon. I'll brighten up the sky. I know I'll never get it. There's not a day that I won't try. I'll say to you, ooh, soon you'll get better.
This is like making me sad because I recently just watched a movie that was kind of like in this realm of theme. It's called, oh my God, what was it called? Taking Cakes to Bars, I think it was called Taking Cakes to Bars. Yara Shahidi was in it. It was so fucking sad. Like, I literally, oh my God, this is what it was reminding me of.
But who am I supposed to talk to? What am I supposed to do?
About
this won't go back to normal if it ever was. It's been years of hoping, and I keep saying it because you have to.
The country songs always get me. Thing Taylor does, she shines when it's like a country cadence song, and that I wasn't expecting that, right, like in the midst of all that pop glory we were just having, and then she just came with this and it's like just brought my mood down. Like, fuck, I think just because I just watched that movie that I was telling you about, sitting in Bars with Cakes, that's the name of the movie, so that just reminded me of that, like the context of the lyrics. I'm like, that's what it was taking me to, so it kind of made me sad, but oh, my song's next. Okay, so listen, I've heard False God. I've heard a lot of songs off of Lover. I've heard False God, but the thing about it is, I have a funny story about False God, which I think is better than the other songs that I already heard before. So I heard Cornelia Street, Cruel Summer, Lover, from just being on the radio or on different, like I've heard it just around because it gets played nonstop, like every, and then I did not know until now that I had already heard Paper Rings, because that gets played a lot. So with False God, what happened was I was actually listening to a playlist and then False God came on. And I didn't even know it was Taylor Swift at first. I was like, what is this? And I looked and it was Taylor Swift. And I was like, what? And then I found out it was on Lover. So I'm like, okay, so I gotta listen to Lover. Because like, False God's on there and I really like that song. Somebody asked me to play a Taylor Swift song. They're like, okay, give me a Taylor Swift, like play a song. I probably would play False God. Because like, this is like, I think her top five. I'm sorry. It is. Like, that, it shook me. Cause I didn't even think it was her, and then I heard it, I'm like, whoa. So that's what really made me listen to Lover, because like I loved Cruel Summer already. I think it's like a great pop song, all-time pop song. Then Lover was good and Cornelia Street was good, so I'm like, okay, Lover might be that girl. Our last sip, False God, I guess. I mean, that's my song, so that makes sense. Okay.
We were crazy to think. Crazy to think that this could work. Remember how I said I'd die for you.
I could not believe this Taylor song.
We were stupid to jump.
Look, look.
And I can't talk to you when you're like this.
I can't.
Staring out the window like I'm not your favorite town. I'm New York City.
I still do it for you, babe. Oh, I got memories in New York.
We still worship this love. We still worship this love.
I know the Swifties were gagged when they heard this song. Like, I know y'all were on y'all knees, like, laid out. Like, because that's how, when I first heard this song, I was like, this song is so good. There's no freaking way. This is Taylor Swift? What? Is that Jack? I'm telling you. I'm going to look it up. I'm going to look it up after, but I know Jack did this. I know he's behind this madness. I know it.
In your lips, even if it's a false god.
I think I love this song so much because I spent a lot of time in New York. Like, I spent a whole summer in New York, and it was like one of the greatest times of my life. And it's like everything that she's saying, like, this was really happening for me. I think that's why I relate to Cornelia Street too. It's like I have a special history with New York that could like never be replicated or like taken away from me. Like, it was just a magical time in my life, and the people I was around and the people I was meeting, like, it was one of the most memorable and just amazing times that I've ever had. It, like, honestly, I would tell anybody that's young, if you get a chance to live in New York and you can do it, because, like, it is something that is just, like, so remarkable and unforgettable. I think everybody deserves that time, like, in New York at some point in their life. You don't even have to be young. If you're 30 and you're, like, one new start, like, New York is just, it's a crazy city. It is just so magical. And songs like this just always take me back to that magic. And I just love New York. I love it. I love New York.
Oh,
she killed that. She killed that song. That, she was in her bag in that song. Like, Taylor Swift was giving me Future on that song. Like, Future would have worked on that song, I'm telling you, because I know my Future music, and I'm telling you, Future could have been on that song, or Future could have made that song. False God, let's keep going before I just, you know, go on a tangent about False God. So the next song is You Need to Calm Down. She talking to another Netflix movie beat.
You are somebody that I don't know, but you're taking shots at me.
Pause. I've heard this song. Taylor, stop. Wait. I've heard this song too. Damn. Did like all these kind of like go charted or something? I've heard this song too. How did I not pull two together? Because doesn't the chorus like, you need to calm down? Duh, girl. Yes. I've heard most of the album. I've heard You Need to Calm Down. But I've never went to listen to You Need to Calm Down like on my own. I've heard that. False God. Cornelia Street. Paper Rings. Lover. Cruel Summer. I mean, no, that's still not a lot. That I guess that's the stuff she put out. So, I mean, that makes sense for me to hear those songs, the singles. Okay, let's keep going.
And I'm just like, hey, are you okay?
Are you okay? Are y'all okay?
And I ain't trying to mess with yourself. You need to calm down. You're being too loud.
Yeah, I've heard this.
And I'm just like, down.
This song and many others on this album, like I said, her voice on them, they just give, these are meant to be heard by the mass majority public. Like, these are gonna be on shows, on commercials, on the radio. Like, these, yeah, Like, but she has that voice for it though, and that's what I like about Taylor Swift, because like, she has a lot of different albums, and from the most part, from what I've heard, everything's kind of different. So like, you know, she's versatile and she knows how to make a radio hit. She knows how to make a commercial hit, but she also knows how to make a very deep cut song too, because like, I feel like something like False God is like a deep cut. Like, that's a deep cut track. And then you have songs like Cardigan, where it's like, Cardigan and You Need to Calm Down are like two totally different songs, but they're by the same artist. And that's what I like about her and many other artists. Like, I like that, you know, there's different things that you can choose from. You don't have to like every single song that Taylor Swift puts out to be a fan. You don't have to like every single album. But it's just like, she has such a big, you know, library. You know, I think there's something for everyone, for sure. If you're a music lover and you just appreciate good music, there is something for everybody in her discography. So it works for me. Okay, so the next song. Oh my God, the next song is the freaking song that we name our drink after, but we don't have any more drink. I don't think, no, we're done. Should we keep drinking, y'all? I'm just trying to figure out, because I don't feel like the Pink Whitney got me lit. Like, how y'all was acting on it, or maybe that says more about me than does you, wait. Because the way people were acting on TikTok, like, oh, Pink Whitney had me blacked out, it had me on the floor. It didn't do anything to me. Or maybe because I'm just drinking a little, like, this was the size of the bottle. I didn't really want to show y'all because I didn't want to get, like, banned or in trouble, but it's not that big. What the fuck? Oh. That happened because I was talking shit about Pink Whitney. Y'all. Oh my God. I literally broke my shot glass. Oh, I'm pissed. Oh, I am pissed. Taylor Swift, send me some new shot glasses. I broke my shot glass because of you. No, it's really not because of you. It's that freaking Pink Whitney that I was trying to show. That's why I shouldn't have tried to show it. Oh my God. Damn it. I guess to answer my question, I don't need to drink anymore. Because obviously something's happening. Okay, so the next song is Afterglow. It is our cocktail name, Afterglow Martini. So this song better be the best. Oh. Not yet, girl. I'm still talking. This song better be the best song on the album. Because we named our martini after it. It was the intuition. I was like, you know, we're going Afterglow. Sounds cute. So let's just pray.
I blew things out of proportion, now you blew. Put you in jail for something you didn't do. I pinned your hands behind your back. Oh, thought I had reason to attack. But no, fighting with a true love is boxing with no gloves.
80s.
Chemistry till it blows up, till there's no us. Why'd I have to break what I love so much? It's on your face, and I'm to blame. I need to say, hey, it's all me in my head.
Woo! Wait a minute!
Bro,
see, this is why Jack, you need to accept my like. It's not even an invitation. It's not even an invitation. It's just like, this is why you need to accept like my beggingness. Because it's not an invitation. Because I'm not inviting. You need to invite me. Because I should have been in the studio with you guys while you were organizing this album. That is my only complaint. Because I feel like, why is Afterglow coming after You Need to Calm Down? That should have been after False God. Those should have been switched. Oh, no. Oh, my God. Jack, listen. Jack, Tay, girl. You know I love you. Listen, mamas. I just want to hang out with y'all. We can drink some wine because I know you like wine. We don't got to drink this Pink Whitney. We don't have to do that. I'm just doing that because we're trying to have a wild night. Listen, I just want to be invited to the next, you know, orchestrating. Because
That's what I do. I'm a curator. I like to curate playlists. I know the sounds and what I'm like. And I'm not saying take that off the album. No. Because I don't think the songs I'm talking about that need to be moved around need to be taken off the album. They're still good songs. Successful songs at that. Order needed to be different, though. Order. Just for my, like, order. I'm a big order person, though. Like, I love a flow. Like, you know them albums that have songs that, like, flow into? Like, I eat that up. Like, I love a flow. So when the flow was not flowing, and it's not even like the album is not flowing. It's just some songs where it's like that could have been there with next to that song. Because they kind of have the same kind of vibe. It's kind of, you know, but I love Afterglow. It's eating.
So excruciating to see you low. Just wanna lift you up, not let you go. This ultraviolet morning light below. It's like an island, punished you with silence. Went off like sirens, just crying.
I like that.
Why'd I have to break what I love so much? It's on your face. Don't walk away, I need to say.
I love pop music sometimes. She sounds great.
That you're still mine. Tell me that we'll be just fine. Even when I lose my mind, I need to say. Tell me that it's not my fault. Tell me that I'm all you want. Even when I break your heart, I need to say. Hey, ooh. It's all me. In my head, I'm the one who burned
what?
Down. But it's not.
Whoa, let's give a dance break. I'm very happy I named my drink after that song.
Yes. A lot of these songs have this very dream poppy sound to it that I just love. Ah. I love it. Makes sense. Because I'm at work, she's in the clouds, and it's very ethereal. So it makes sense. Okay, so the next song is me featuring Brendon. I never can say his last name. Is it Brendon? Urie, a Panic of the Disco. I used to love Panic of the Disco. Long time ago. Long time ago. I used to love Panic of the Disco when I was in middle school. So let's see if this song is good. I like both of them, so.
I promise that you'll never find another like me. I know that I'm a handful.
Netflix song. I mean, I can hear it as soon as it starts. Like, I just know.
Baby, I know I never think before I jump. And you're the kind of guy the ladies want. And there's a lot of cool chicks out there. I know that I would psych when it
it's
comes
like giving
to
band.
I promise that you'll never find another like me.
That chorus I've heard. So is that on TV too? So damn, she had a lot of singles then. Are just songs that charted or something, because I've heard that I don't know where though. Maybe just on TV. Like YouTube something. But I've heard that though. I haven't heard his part though. I've heard that little piece though. Okay. And once again, this will be in the category with You Need to Calm Down, Paper Rings, I Think He Knows, and I Forgot You Existed. For sure. These all needed to be next to each other in some capacity, I feel like. The spread it out of them, I don't like that.
About me, I know you never get just what you see, but I will never fall you, baby. And when we had that fight out in the rain, you
kind of interesting hearing him on this kind of beat. I don't know. It's interesting. This don't sound like a Panic at the Disco. I mean, does it? It kind of sounds like 5 in the afternoon a little bit. I could say this has a 5 in the afternoon kind of sound. Well, let's keep going. And I promise that nobody's gonna love you like me. Okay. Okay. Definitely in the category. I'm not gonna say it again. Okay. I really believe those songs all should have been next to each other. I do. That one was alright. It was cool. It wasn't like, it didn't take me aback. Like, whoa! Like, that after Afterglow is like, no, no, no. Because, why is Afterglow surrounded by me and You Need to Calm Down? Afterglow deserves to be next to False God. It does. Because those two songs are like, out of this fucking world. They deserve to be next to each other. So we only have two songs left, and it is It's Nice to Have a Friend and Daylight. So far, I was kind of eating. It's cute, and it's just, it's different because, it's just different. Because I wouldn't say, I mean, the vibes are different. Like, it's definitely not the Folklore vibe. Like, that is like a totally different thing. But I like this vibe, though. It's pop. Taylor's a pop girly. She is. I'm going to tell you one thing. She can do a lot of different things, and she has proved that she can make that transition from country to pop. She did it with this, for sure. I mean, she really did it with 1989. I haven't listened to that whole album, but I have heard at least 5 songs from that, and all of them are, like, pop royalty. Like, Wildest Dreams, Style. Let's be serious. Like, I already told y'all Style's one of my favorite songs. But anyway, so let's get into It's Nice to Have a Friend.
School bell rings, walk me home, sidewalk chalk covered in snow, lost my gloves, you give me one,
give me this.
Wanna hang, nice to have a friend.
This is kind of scaring me a little bit. Something about the ooze.
Stressed out lately, yeah, me too. Something gave you the nerve.
Something about this has like a
hand. It's nice to have a friend.
Is there gonna be a drop? Because something about this is giving me Silent Hill. Something about this beat give me Silent Hill. I'm sorry, it is. Yeah, it's nice it's to scary. Have a friend. That kind of felt like an interlude to me. Low-key. It was giving, like, interlude vibes. Okay. 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 Cool, cool, cool. Okay, so we're on our last track now. Damn, we finally made it here. This is crazy. The lover party was successful, guys. I got lit. We jammed out. We did makeup. We did a lot, actually. I'm actually, like, impressed with my face because we were struggling in the beginning, but then it came together. Purr. So we're on our last song, Daylight. She better come correct with Daylight because this will make or break the album for me, I think. I really do. I really think it will. Not saying make or break like it's good or bad. It will just make or break for me personally. So let's see.
My love was as cruel as the cities I lived in.
Woo! I've lived in New York and I've lived in LA, so I feel that. And those are some cruel cities. Oh, okay. Keep going.
Everyone looked worse in the light. There are so many lines that I've crossed unforgiven. I'll tell you the truth, but never goodbye. I don't want to look at anything else now that I saw you.
The
draw only draws.
love it.
Dream pop. She's in her dream pop bag. Why she end the album like that? Why should I do that? Ooh. Outro. Ugh, we gotta get some things, you guys, because I kind of ate up Daylight. I kind of love that song. You know what? I am gonna give it Lover a thumbs up. Two thumbs up. Every single song on here was a good song, was a banger, but order is what kind of messed me up, and the order can make you believe that certain songs are flops, because it's like, why is this coming on, right? Like, you just took, like, you put me into one zone, and then another song comes on and it just takes you out of that zone and takes you, like, you know. And I don't like to be zoned around. Like, I think, let's break down Taylor Swift. This was a very chaotic album reaction first listen. I mean, I broke my shot glass. So, I mean, that has to mean we had a good time, right? We finished the whole Pinguini bottle. We finished all our cocktail, our Afterglow cocktail. We did the face. And I enjoyed myself. I think this was the perfect album to do that to. It was, like, just long enough and poppy and fun and cunty and just, like, cute. And I wasn't in my feelings a lot. There were some songs where there's some things that she was saying, I was like, oh, like, take me. Like, but, like, I wasn't overwhelmingly sad. Like, it was a good mix of just different moods. Overall, I enjoyed it. I had a great time. This was so fucking fun. I actually want to do more of these. I want to do more makeup and drinking and just vibing, because this was super fun. Maybe I should do Reputation next. Because I know Reputation is controversial for a lot of people. I know Swifties loved it, but I know it was, like, controversial when she dropped it, like, for, like, press, from what I just know from the internet. And people were talking a lot of mad crap about her. So I'm like, maybe I need to listen to Reputation next. And we should do Reputation drink and Reputation look. Oh my God, do like a smoky, smoky dark eye. Like, yeah, we're going to be real intense, like, model look. I mean, I don't know if you guys can see the look I did. You probably can't even freaking tell, to be honest. But, like, I did a little pink. It looks cute, like, in the mirror. But, like, I did pink and, you know, pink lip. Like, it's cute. I think it's cute. But I think I'm going to do Reputation next. Party, this was so fun. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I mean, I know this is something different. Like, I've never done something like this before. You know, I've done reactions. But I just wanted to add in, you know, just a different feel. And I'm going to try to do different things. Like, I'm not always going to be, like, getting blackout wasted on here. I might, you know, do some other activities. Because sometimes I just don't want to sit and just, like, listen. So
You know, we'll make it fun. We'll see. I mean, if you guys like this, let me know. Like, comment, subscribe. You know where to find me. My other socials are right here. Boom, follow me, keep up. But I'm loving this Taylor Swift journey. I am like, shout out to the Swifties. Y'all are on the right path. I'm telling you right now. Y'all bitches was right. Like I said the first time, y'all bitches was right. That girl, she's a musician. And if you hate on it, then you are like literally a freaking hater. Like you are a true hater. And you have to live with that because I'm not a hater. I appreciate good music when it's good. So, period. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I had so much fun. I'm literally about to pass out because the pink Whitney is hitting me. And I'm just like, oh my God. I thought I was going to be like more blacked by this point, but I'm not. But maybe when I lay down, it's going to start. Like, I'm scared. Like, I'm scared to like get out of this seat because I've been sitting here for like literally an hour. I feel like once I get up, it's going to like hit me. So, we'll see. But I hope you guys had a good time and tune in next time. Bye.